Hi, welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm bringing you the ultimate advanced guide for the latest version of Lossless Scaling. At first, I'll show you exactly how to use frame generation. Then I'll reveal how to unlock the hidden potential of your integrated graphic card for frame generation, effectively transforming it into a frame generation chip. After that, we'll tap into the power of FSR upscaling to improve your performance while maintaining high image quality. And finally, outline how to combine both techniques for an even better gaming experience. Each of these methods has its own unique setup, so make sure you stick around until the very end to catch all the exclusive tips and tricks. Let's kick things off with frame generation, a technique that interpolates motion vectors and predicts intermediate frames between rendered ones, effectively boosting your FPS. Make sure your model is set to LSFG 3.0. This is the latest algorithm that provides the best quality for frame generation. If you are using fixed mod, you can choose from preset multipliers like 2x, 3x, or 4x, or if you want even more, you can go up to a 20x multiplier. And also, for fixed mod, it is crucial to cap your FPS to a value that remains stable at least 90% of the time. I recommend using RioTuner for this. At least 30 FPS is essential for high quality frame generation. Alright, let's tackle the biggest addition in this update. Previously, the only option was fixed frame generation. This mod relies entirely on your game's base frame rate. Let me explain. If your game ran at 30 FPS and you used 2x frame generation, you would get 60 FPS. But if your frame rate dipped down to 25 FPS, the generated frame rate would also drop to 50 FPS. Not only that, but frame generation was locked to whole number multipliers, from 2x all the way to 20x. So if you wanted a smooth 144Hz experience, you would have to cap your game at 72 FPS and use 2x frame generation. Now, with adaptive frame generation, things are different. You can target any frame rate you want, regardless of your game's FPS. If your base frame rate changes, the frame generation dynamically adjusts to maintain your target value. No more strict multipliers or awkward compromises. This is a big step forward for a smooth, flexible gameplay. While this new mod is a massive improvement, it is important to know its limitations. Fractional multipliers like 1.5x or 1.8x won't lighten the load compared to 2x frame generation, because fractional multipliers rely on generating more frames than real ones, unlike integer multipliers, which show more real frames. The cost of running fractional frame generation at 1.5x is almost the same as running 2x frame generation. So if you are running at 40 FPS and aiming for 60, you might be better off aiming for 80 FPS with 2x frame generation, giving you a smoother results and roughly the same GPU cost. Flow scale is safe to tweak, not having noticeable effect on your visuals, but increasing it has a significant impact on your GPU load. For Capture API, use the XGI for systems running below Windows 11 24H2. Switch to WGC for Windows 11 24H2. In the new UI, you might notice a new option called Queue Target. Let me quickly explain what it does and how you can use it to fine-tune your frame generation experience. Value 0 is for lowest latency. This is ideal if you have a capped FPS and low GPU load. If you are all about responsiveness, this is the way to go. 1 is a balanced option. It is a recommended choice for most users, striking a mix between latency and frame generation performance. If you are unsure, just leave it at 1. It is the safest bet. And 2, for unstable and uncapped FPS and high GPU load. This setting will keep your target FPS ready and smooth. Essentially, pick 0 if you are chasing latency and have control over your frame rate. Stick to 1 if you want something safe, and go for 2 if you are running on the edge with high GPU usage and fractional frame generation mod. Before we test the game, make sure that your game runs in windowed or borderless mode. Full screen won't work with the app. And if you are running an HDR monitor, Turn on HDR support to ensure vibrant and accurate colors. All right, let's test that. Note that LSFG 3.0 has been known to have problems with SRI patterns. One of the coolest tricks is using your integrated graphic card for frame generation, effectively delivering free FPS without overloading your dedicated GPU. Here's the key point. Direct connection is the key. This method only works if your output monitor is your laptop's display, connected directly to the integrated graphic card. If you are using an external monitor linked to your dedicated GPU, you won't get any benefit. By offloading frame generation tasks to the integrated graphic card, your main GPU can focus on rendering high-quality visuals without compromise. Next, let's improve your frame rate using FSR. Follow these steps. Begin by lowering your game resolution. In my case, I set my game resolution to HD. Change your mod to custom and enable resize before scaling. Tweak the scale factor to get the best balance between quality and performance. 1.3 equals to ultra quality, perfect for when you need top-notch visual fidelity. 1.5 equals to quality, a solid balance for most games. 1.7 equals to balanced, offers a middle ground between performance and clarity. And 2.0 equals to performance, best if you are chasing higher FPS, although the auto mode is suggested. When combining frame generation and upscaling, you need to follow a specific sequence. First, remove any frame rate limit to let the upscaling process run freely. After running the game with upscaling once, set a new frame rate limit if you are using fixed mode for frame generation. Then re-enable frame generation, so it works with a newly stabilized frame limit. If you are using adaptive mode, there is no need for a frame rate cap. This order of operations ensures that both upscaling and frame generation work harmoniously for the smoothest gaming experience. That wraps up for our advanced guide to lossless scaling. If you found these tips helpful, drop a like, hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.